chestnuts roasting. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. So I'm offering a simple phrase. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. Chestnuts roasting. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. So I'm offering a simple phrase. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas.
Hey guys, and welcome back to another vlog. So in the footage before this, I just redid the Christmas tree. I really just wanted to redo it because the first time we did it was kind of just rushed and we just kind of like threw stuff onto the Christmas tree. I like to kind of like look at a Christmas tree and see exactly where things need to go. So I bought a few new ornaments and just kind of went shopping for some Christmas stuff and basically just redid the tree, which was really, really fun. And then I tried to like hide the base of the tree because I hate those like little legs. I try to hide those with like fake presents. There's nothing in those boxes, I promise you. And like little baskets and stuff just to make it look really cute and cozy. This is like, I have a lot of makeup on right now. Like, look at this highlighter, how crazy. So I kind of went for a Christmassy look. I've been so excited just to get into like the festive season and just do some looks inspired by Christmas and, you know, all the nice jolly jolly things. But we are finally going to assemble this unit that I have in the lounge over there, which I have had sitting there, I think it's almost 3 weeks now, and we can finally organize my makeup nicely. Just wanted to show you guys these storage units that I have. So I got these from Clix. They are really affordable and they have like the silicone non-slip and like gripping material on the bottom, so whatever drawer you put it into, they aren't going to slip and slide up and down Rodeo Drive. They're just really great quality and you can stack a lot of things in here. So let me rinse off and get rid of all of this makeup, change into some comfy clothes, and we can assemble this unit and let's get into the beautiful organization of makeup. What a time, man, what a time. Oh, also very random, I just got this PR package and this is a new self tanning brand that is launching in South Africa. It looks like this. This kind of reminds me of the Caribbean tan bottle because of the colors and stuff, but this is what it looks like. And it came with a really cute like tanning mitt as well. I really wanted to tan like yesterday, but I didn't have time, so I think I'm definitely going to do that tonight after I assemble this unit. Also, these Builders Warehouse units are not easy to assemble. Whatever footage you are about to see, magnify the effort and time times 100. Let's go. You're not interested in this at all. Hey guys, so it is the next day. Putting that unit together was a mission and a half. It took so long. So it is the next day now and it is so hot that I'm just wearing one of these like little cotton on bralettes. I did this self tanner last night. I'm so brown. I don't know if you guys can see the difference. I'm just wearing a little bit of concealer today. The difference is crazy. This is incredible and it smells so nice. It doesn't have that weird like self tanner smell. It smells kind of like peaches. That's what it reminds me of. But I thought it is the perfect time to do the storage. Look at her face. I thought it's the perfect time to finally do this whole makeup storage scenario. Okay, all right, okay, Let me put this down a bit so you guys can see what we're working with. I got this from, I think it was Sheet Street. Yeah, Sheet Street for 90 Rand. And I'm just going to put my palettes in here. This is obviously one of those like dish dryer racks, but I wanted to put my palettes neatly over here. I just liked how it had like this section in the front over here. I thought that was different to anything else I had seen. And I feel like this is just a really easy, affordable, and quick way to store your palettes. In this drawer over here, I've just got all of these storage units that I got from, I think all of them are actually from Clix, so they all look like this. And then I've also got some of these acrylic ones, which are also from Clix. I'm literally dying of heat. When I was at the shops, I also saw that the store at home also has really nice like acrylic storage units. They obviously, I think they're quite a bit more pricey compared to Clix, but they had also really nice like acrylic storage units, and they were very different, so they didn't look like this. They had like different layers and they had like three sections and stuff. So if you are looking for other types of like acrylic storage, go have a look there, because I know that they have ones as well. And then the makeup desk, I just gave it a really nice clean and I just put things out in the open so that I can organize that nicely as well. It's really random, but if you have dust in your drawer like I do over there, I just use my hairdryer and you kind of just get the dust out like that, and then you can obviously clean the floor later. So I'm now going to take all of the highlighters that I use most often. So this is probably my most used highlighter ever. This is the Revlon Skin Lights Highlighter in 201 Daybreak Glimmer. It's incredible. It's so good. So I'm going to put this right at the front and just stack it with other ones that I love. So I'm basically putting my most important ones at the front. Then I think I need to fit like another one or two things in here because I want this to like be really nice and compact. So, what am I gonna do? I'm actually just gonna put a blush in here as well. This is the Milani blush, which is so beautiful. I love this one. This is gonna be so satisfying. Oh, it fits perfectly. And I guess through this exercise, you guys now know what my favorite highlighters are in order. Okay, so that is going to go in there. This is really more difficult than I thought. These are just like really difficult because of the size of these things. I'm just trying to think of how I can store these nicely. You know what? Let me look on Pinterest. There's such beautiful storage ideas, but literally no one shows how to store your primers. I'm guessing the easiest way is to store them upright, but I really want to keep them in this drawer, and this obviously doesn't fit, so I don't know what to do. I'm gonna come back to that drawer because I don't know what to do with that. What I'm gonna do now is, this is like my problem drawer. I have no idea what to do with all of these concealers and my mascaras, so I just quickly cleaned this with some Sunlight dishwashing liquid, and this is clean and ready to go. I bought this so long ago, I'm not joking. I think I've had this for like 8 years, 10 years, so I have no idea where this is from, unfortunately. So let me add all of my crazy amounts of concealers into this little thing. I'm gonna put my mascaras in the middle. Ooh, she's my favorite. This is the best mascara ever. These are the best. Don't even come for me. Don't fight with me. These are incredible. Mwah. I unfortunately need to say goodbye to this mascara, which is one of the best mascaras ever. Look at this wand. It's so, so good. But I don't know if everyone knows this. I know quite a few people actually don't know this, but if you look at the back of your mascara, it says over here, it has like this little tub with a 6 and an M on it. That means 6 months. That's how long you should have this for. So I've had this for, oh, I don't even want to know. I don't even want to know. Too long. So I'm going to throw this guy away. Also, don't sleep on Love Cosmetics mascaras. These are flippin' incredible. And these are epic. These are from Benefit. I got sent these when I did a campaign with them. And these are like eyebrow gels basically, but they come in different colors. So this is a pink one and I have like a purple one as well. I'm actually gonna put these with my eyeliners and stuff because I don't use these often. Ooh, another really incredible mascara. I'm gonna use this top drawer over here for all of my eyebrow products. And trust me, we got a lot. Gonna put my Benefit Brow Zings palette in there as well. That is so much better. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use one of these little units. This is also from Clix. I got another one of these as well. And I'm putting all of my tiny little products that I have in here. So these are just like glow sticks. Oh, I love this. From Benefit. These are little primers over here. And these cute Benefit like lip and cheek stains. So these are all just my little products. Most of them are actually like glow products and primers. It's a little baby. So cute. Okay, so this is dedicated to the boys that are a little bit too tall. So I'm just going to lie them down like that. So I'm just going to put this in here and see. Okay, that fits nicely. So I've just kind of put all the primers that I use the most at the bottom over here, and then I've got a few over here that I either haven't used yet or I don't actually use that often. That looks so much better compared to what we had there before. Okay, next, do you guys want to see something scary? This drawer full of foundations, which are just thrown into a drawer. So let's do something about that. See, this is also another tricky thing to store nicely because, again, I don't have that much space. So we need to figure out a solution. Just really quickly, if you are no makeup, makeup kind of girl, this is one of the best things ever. It's the NYX Bare With Me Tinted Skin Veil. It's so beautiful. Gives a very, like, natural coverage to the skin, but definitely gives, like, at least some sort of coverage. And this is another one of my faves. It's so good. Okay, my foundations, I've just realized, are not going to fit in here. So let's put them into the new storage unit. That literally fits perfectly. And then I've just got all of my stick foundations in here. So I've just laid the products out from this drawer underneath on my table over here. So I have my powders, I've got some blushes and some highlighters that I use like not so often, and then some bronzers. So I wanted to use my most used products from those over there in here so that I can put them neatly next to this one. And then I think I'm just going to organize these nicely in terms of height. And those are my most used blushes, bronzers, and I've got a highlighter in there, and my powders. And I love this blush so much. It's so, so good. And then I'm going to use one of these units for this drawer over here to put most of my other powders in here. Okay, I actually changed my mind. I'm going to redo this again and rather use these two. And then I'm thinking for this drawer over here, I'm wanting to maybe use one of these or one of these, just little items from my makeup desk that I can put in here to put into the drawers. So let me find what I want to put in here. So from this exercise, I've noticed that, okay, it depends on what kind of storage you have and like what drawers you're using, but these for me currently are not as handy. I definitely think I should have stocked up on more of these. I have, I think, 4 of these or 5 of these in total, and they're just so nice because they're so long and they just fit and stack so many powders or blushes or bronzers, whatever it is. So I highly recommend this one the most out of everything. Like literally, if you see these, go ham and buy 100. They're so good. I'm now kind of wishing that I bought a few more of those long ones. And then what I actually ended up deciding on what to do with this drawer is, this might sound ridiculous, but when I do my makeup looks, I use my skincare that I don't use as often. So I've just got my cotton earbuds, which I use to clean up after my looks. And then I've just got my Garnier Micellar Water, which is also something I use very often, mostly in conjunction with this when I do my makeup looks. So I also thought that this is maybe better to have here instead of having it on the makeup desk. Okay, so next we have makeup palettes. I'm going to come back to the desk a bit later. So I'm just going to stack everything nicely. I've got most of my makeup palettes over here now. So I'm just going to stack them all nicely into this. I'm just going to stack this very roughly for now, and then I'll make it look nice later. I got sent these in PR from Pons, which I need to sort out just now. But this is basically, these are all my favorites. These are probably my most used makeup palettes. So my favorite palette in the world, which is my Carnival 3 Love Tahiti palette, which looks like this. She Had to Be Here. Of course, my Jaclyn Hill palette, literally one of my most used palettes ever. And my favorite affordable palette on the planet is this Catrice Pro Slim Eyeshadow Palette. It's the Next Gen Nudes palette, which looks like this. It's just so beautiful. It had to be here. I've got some of my favorites, like my Too Faced Peachy palette, and some of these beautiful like ColourPop palettes. This is another ColourPop palette, which I just love. And I just feel like having these over here and just having them displayed like this nicely is going to get me super excited when I walk into this room before I film a makeup tutorial or do a makeup look. These are palettes that obviously I love. I don't keep anything that I don't use or, you know, things like that. But these are my palettes that I don't use as often as these ones over here. So this is just one of these little little baskets that I got from Clix, and I highly recommend this. It's just such an easy way to store your makeup palettes, and it makes everything nice and neat. So I did these all according to height. And then these over here, most of these are like face palettes that I have over here. This is one of my favorites. It's the best. And then this one as well, I do use these, but these are not the ones that I think deserve like the limelight. So I'm just going to keep this one shining bright on this unit. And then these two we can put into the drawer. Then I wanted to add like a nice candle over here just for vibes, man. Just for the vibes. Just wondering if I should maybe keep it like that. Yeah, I think that actually looks a little bit better. Better use of space as well. It looks so much neater. It's crazy. I was thinking of spray painting this white or, I don't know, black or something, but I actually don't mind this. It's not like really ugly. I mean, I know it's literally meant to dry your dishes, but it doesn't look bad at all. And here we have our finished makeup organization and makeup room. Here I've just got all of my like most used lipsticks, and these are all kind of like nude colors. These are just all the things that I use the most. And then over here, I actually need to take these off. I've got all of my hair ties. I need these quite often when I shoot my videos. I've got all of my like lip glosses, all of my setting sprays, and of course my beauty blenders in this little container, which is so, so cute. And then I'm so happy that I've used this little unit here. I've got all of my eyebrow products over there, all of my mascaras, and then my concealers on the bottom, my little flowers and a candle, and of course my mirror that I use. This really does just look so much better and so much neater, and I cannot wait to film a makeup tutorial with this whole new setup. So that's the makeup desk over here. I've got my ring light, and then here we have the new unit. I'm really into these candle vibes, if you haven't noticed. So I have all of my favorite palettes over here, and then on this side I have a few other palettes, and then this is just a little bag full of my hair accessories. So I've just got tons and tons of like hair ties, hair clips, and all of that kind of a thing, and I use this quite often, so I thought that this is the perfect place to have that over there. Then in the second drawer I have all of my skincare. I actually really wanted to throw this away, but it's actually quite handy for this over here. So I've got all of my like sheet masks, some other kind of mask, and then I have some face wipes over here. And I've got these massive cotton pads, which I got from overseas. These are huge. They can literally remove makeup from your whole face. They're like massive. Then I have this makeup remover cloth that I haven't used yet. I've got this cute little headband, which I got from Ponds, which I thought would be nice to live over here. And then this is mostly for all of my favorite serums and the things that I use very, very often. So things like this from Avène, my favorite sun cream, and my favorite little masks over here. And then on this side, a little bit more skincare as well, so like some of my favorite masks, my eye creams. I've got a few other moisturizers over here. I always change up my skincare routine. I don't have like a set skincare routine, so I use quite a few like different products. And then last but definitely not least, we have the bottom drawer, and this is just for all of my hair care. So these are all like my hair tools, like my straighteners and all of that kind of a thing. Got my hair drying neatly over here so that I can reach it easily. And then these are all of my hair products, like my hair oils, dry shampoo, volumizing mousse, and that kind of a thing. And that brings us to the end of this vlog. I really hope you guys enjoyed this one. It was so much fun to organize things and just finally have my makeup room like good and ready to go. So I've already used the makeup table. It's so nice to have everything organized and in its place. I'm still trying to like figure out where everything is, so I'll get used to that. Just quickly did my makeup now. I did a very like quick wing and just natural skin, like glowy skin, because I'm filming a campaign with Clix. This is their beauty box, so definitely keep an eye out on my Instagram so that you guys can see that. I got the most beautiful fragrance. This is the Elizabeth Arden White Tea Wild Rose. Oh my goodness, guys, you have no idea how good this smells. I got the little bottle. Oh my gosh, it's so divine. It's like really like rosy but very fresh at the same time. It kind of reminds me a little bit of the Tommy Hilfiger perfume. I tried out a new mascara today because it was actually in the Clix Beauty Box. This is the L'Oreal Lash Paradise. It made my lashes look so beautiful and like full and fluffy, so I'm really enjoying that. So for the campaign, which I need to shoot like literally right now, I'm halfway through filming, I've got a few more things to do. I'm leaving to go to Joburg for Christmas, so I have to literally get this done today. I got the box and the brief for the campaign today, so I need to get this done ASAP. So I always just write everything out. I'm just feeling really grateful right now because in my little book I wrote down that one of my goals for this year was to do a campaign with Clix, and it's literally the end of the year and now I'm doing this campaign, so I'm just so excited. I love doing stuff like this. It's just sometimes really hard because I work full-time. I've had to say no to so many campaigns and so many brands that I've really wanted to work with, so I'm so excited that this came at the right time. I have the time now before I fly to Joburg. When is it? Tomorrow? The next day? But yeah, I'm so happy that this room is done. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video today. Don't forget to like and subscribe and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye! Okay, I'm procrastinating. I need to get this done now.